Hello everyone, and welcome back to the series of lectures on cross-couplings. So far, we have mainly focused on examining the most prominent ligands and catalysts in the field. This lecture will be devoted to describing the reactivity of the most frequently used coupling partners in cross-couplings and how the reactivity of substrates can be altered by the choice of a suitable catalytic system. Aryl halides are the most commonly used electrophilic coupling partners in cross-coupling chemistry. Numerous high-yielding methodologies exist for preparing aryl chlorides and aryl bromides, making them readily available commercial building blocks for organic synthesis. Not only are aryl chlorides and aryl bromides employed as electrophilic coupling partners, but they also serve as the most frequently utilized starting materials for the preparation of organometallics. The nucleophilic coupling partners and cross-couplings. In contrast, aryl iodides and aryl fluorides are less common and are not easily obtained from conventional reagents. Four main factors control the reactivity of electrophilic coupling partners: the strength of the bond, polarity, polarizability of the carbon-heteroatom bond, and steric hindrance around the bond. In highly reactive electrophilic coupling partners, the carbon-heteroatom bond should not be too strong. It should be polar and polarizable, and preferably, it should not be surrounded by bulky groups. When considering these factors, we establish a general order of reactivity for aryl halides. Aryl iodides are the most reactive, followed by aryl bromides and aryl chlorides. The carbon-fluorine bond is strong and rigid, making aryl fluorides the least reactive systems for oxidative addition. Here, one can observe the periodic trends in action. Moving down the periodic table increases the polarizability of the carbon-halogen bond, rendering it more reactive for oxidative addition to the catalyst. When considering other elements, the electrophilic coupling partners are referred to as pseudohalides. Here, the group 2 elements connected to the aromatic ring are illustrated. The reactivities of these systems differ significantly from aryl halides. While carbon-oxygen and carbon-nitrogen bonds in anisoles and anilines remain polar and somewhat polarizable, the carbon-carbon bond is nonpolar, and organoboron reagents are more prone to undergo transmetallation. Steric effects become crucial in this context, with the carbon-heteroatom bond becoming more sterically hindered as we move left in the periodic table. Another factor significantly reducing the reactivity of anisoles and anilines toward oxidative addition is the conjugation. Due to conjugation, the lone pairs of electrons at the heteroatom in anisoles and anilines are shared with the aromatic system. This conjugation gives the carbon-heteroatom bond a double bond character, making it more rigid, less polarizable, and stronger than single bonds. Conjugation and phenol derivatives can be minimized by substituting the oxygen with strong electron withdrawing groups. This modification can render phenol derivatives suitable electrophilic coupling partners for cross-coupling reactions. The most successful electron withdrawing groups applied to phenols are triflate, mesylate, and tosylate. Aryl triflates have proven to be excellent coupling partners in cross-couplings, exhibiting higher reactivity than aryl mesylates and tosylates, which are still useful coupling partners demonstrating comparable reactivities. Alternatively, phenols can be protected in the form of acetates, carbonates, and carbamates. However, these systems do not exhibit a notable tendency to undergo oxidative addition and require special catalysts and conditions. For aniline derivatives, conjugation can be discontinued through the preparation of ammonium salts, nitro compounds, and diazonium compounds. Diazonium compounds stand out as superior electrophilic coupling partners for cross-coupling chemistry. As you may recall, they were first applied by Meerwein, and metal-catalyzed transformations involving diazonium compounds are frequently referred to as Meerwein cross-coupling reactions. Ammonium salts are not suitable coupling partners because the introduction of the third alkyl group at nitrogen makes these systems considerably sterically hindered. Although the carbon-nitrogen bond in nitro compounds is highly polar, these systems are also not ideal coupling partners. Here, we encounter another type of conjugation where electrons are donated from the aromatic ring to the nitro group. This, in turn, imparts a partial double bond character to the carbon-nitrogen bond and increases the rigidity of the bond. Although carbon-carbon bonds are nonpolar, they can be made polar by oxidizing the methyl group. Carboxylic acids and their derivatives constitute an emerging group of coupling partners for cross-coupling chemistry. However, the mechanisms of reactions involving these substrates can differ significantly from those with aryl halides. Decarboxylations typically involve radicals and may even generate anionic intermediates similar to organometallics. Nitriles are another promising group of electrophilic coupling partners. Here, the carbon-carbon bond is polar, and the system is not particularly sterically hindered. It should be noted that research on the application of nitriles in cross-coupling reactions is still in its infancy. The sustainability and atom economy of reactions involving carbon-carbon bond activation can be questioned, as the primary goal of cross-coupling chemistry is to create carbon-carbon bonds rather than break them. Summarizing this section, it should be noted that the most reactive electrophilic coupling partners are aryl iodides and diazonium compounds. Unfortunately, they are not readily available, and additionally, diazonium compounds are explosive. The second best electrophilic coupling partners, in terms of reactivity, are aryl bromides and aryl triflates. These compounds are notably more reactive than aryl chlorides, which, in turn, are more preferable than other sulfonates. Reactions involving aryl chlorides, mesylates, and tosylates are typically facilitated by bulky and strong sigma donor ligands. Other electrophilic coupling partners, such as acetates, nitro compounds, and derivatives of carboxylic acids, either require nickel-based catalysts or specific ligands and reaction conditions. The concluding part of this lecture will feature selected examples. Now, let's discuss organometallic coupling partners. The primary factor controlling their reactivity is the electronegativity of the metal. The less electronegative the metal, the more nucleophilic the organic subunit connected to the metal becomes. This, in turn, facilitates a more straightforward transmetallation. Another supporting factor for the transmetallation from these organometallics is that the byproduct inorganic salts, such as magnesium bromide, are not soluble in organic solvents. They usually precipitate from the reaction media, favoring the transmetallation. Organometallics based on metalloids are typically less reactive, enabling good functional group tolerance. However, these substrates often require a base for activation. It's worth noting that the base is not always necessary for organotin reagents. Now, let me describe how one can influence the activity of your coupling partners. The reactivity of an electrophilic coupling partner can be enhanced by introducing electron withdrawing groups into the system. Conversely, the introduction of electron donating groups effectively reduces the reactivity of the electrophilic coupling partner. Electron withdrawing groups increase the electron deficiency of the system, subsequently enhancing the polarity of the carbon-halogen bond. Meanwhile, electron-donating groups raise the electron density in the system and increase the rigidity of the carbon-halogen bond. For example, perchlorobenzotrifluoride is a better coupling partner than 4-chloroanisole. Similarly, nitrophenyl triflate is more reactive in cross-couplings than aryl triflates possessing electron-donating groups. The opposite is true for organometallic coupling partners. Organometallics possessing electron-donating groups are more nucleophilic and are better substrates for transmetallation compared to those having electron-withdrawing groups. To be more specific, boronic acids equipped with methoxy groups are more reactive in Suzuki couplings than boronic acids with fluorine substituents. Organotin reagents based on electron-rich 5-membered heterocycles are better substrates in still coupling than organotin reagents possessing electron-withdrawing carbonyl groups. Here, it is essential to remember that the increased reactivity of organometallics based on electron-rich systems can be complicated by the instability of the systems and unwanted side reactions. In fact, some organometallics based on electron-rich 5-membered heterocycles are quite unstable. What you learned in this lecture should allow you to design your synthesis involving cross-couplings more rationally. If you are tasked to prepare this purine derivative, then you can start your retrosynthesis from the disconnection of the bond in red. For the overall efficiency of the process, you can consider the Suzuki coupling based on electron-rich trimethoxyphenyl boronic acid and electron-deficient chlorinated purine derivative depicted here. If you want to prepare the commercial drug canagliflozin, used to treat type 2 diabetes, then you can start your retrosynthesis by disconnecting the bond between thiophene and fluorobenzene. You can think about the application of the still coupling based on the use of electron-deficient 4-fluorobromobenzene and an electron-rich derivative of 2-tributylstanylthiophene. In the last section of this lecture, I want to highlight selected cross-couplings involving challenging substrates such as anisoles, esters, and nitro compounds. The activation of non-traditional substrates is a hot topic in this field. In 2008, an interesting report came from the group of Chatani, describing the first Suzuki coupling using anisoles instead of aryl halides. The reaction was enabled by a nickel-zero pre-catalyst combined with the bulky and strong sigma donor tricyclohexylphosphine. The reported substrate scope was quite narrow and predominantly based on polycyclic arenes possessing a methoxy group. It was suggested that oxidative addition, including fused arenes, happens more readily. Therefore, there is still room for further elaboration of this strategy. Although the reaction mechanism was not examined, it is plausible that the reaction proceeds through a typical cross-coupling mechanism initiated by the oxidative addition of the carbon-oxygen bond to the nickel-zero precatalyst, followed by transmetallation of the aryl group from boronic ester and reductive elimination to form the biaryl. A few years later, they could demonstrate that the limitation of predominantly using fused arenes can be overcome by the application of NHC ligands. Here, among others, you can see the comparison of the results for the reactions performed with the NHC ligand L7 with those obtained for tricyclohexylphosphine. The catalysts based on phosphine ligands were typically not active for substrates other than fused arenes. Computational studies on the mechanism of the reaction suggest that the NHC ligand makes the nickel sufficiently electron-rich, thus allowing the cleavage of the carbon-oxygen bond in simple anisoles. In 2015, the group of Itami was among the first to report that esters of aryl carboxylic acids can be suitable electrophilic coupling partners for the reactions involving boronic acids. The catalytic system enabling this transformation was based on nickel acetate and a strong sigma-donor but non-bulky tributylphosphine. The major drawback of the developed methodology was the need to use a very high reaction temperature. The substrate scope demonstrated in the report was also impressive, and a small portion of the products with corresponding yields is presented here. With a user-friendly and inexpensive nickel catalyst, a range of phenol esters of aromatic, heteroaromatic, and aliphatic carboxylic acids react with boronic acids in a decarbonylative manner. They computationally examined the mechanism of the Suzuki coupling reaction. Presumably, the first step of the process is the oxidative addition of the nickel-zero pre-catalyst to the carbonyl-phenoxy bond of the ester. This is noteworthy as the acyl-oxygen bond is the weakest bond in the molecule. The oxidative addition is followed by transmetallation of the aryl group from boronic acid to the nickel-2 intermediate. Surprisingly, the transmetallation is not followed by the reductive elimination of the derivative of benzophenone. Instead, the transmetallation is followed by a decarbonylation leading to intermediate F. The decarbonylation is also feasible as the insertion of arenes to carbon monoxide is a reversible process. The reductive elimination predominantly happens after the decarbonylation, leading to the corresponding biaryl. The need for high temperatures in the reaction is justified by the necessity to facilitate the release of carbon monoxide from intermediate G, which possibly prevents the poisoning of the catalyst. Until 2017, nitro compounds were rare substrates for cross-coupling reactions, despite being readily available commercial substrates and common intermediates in the preparation of aryl halides by the Sandmeyer reaction. The limited use of nitro compounds in metal-catalyzed reactions is due to the nitro group acting as a mild oxidant toward low-valent transition metals, leading to nitroso compounds and other reduction products. The group of Nakao successfully overcame this limitation and achieved the coupling of nitroarenes with aryl boronic acids using a palladium Bretfoss catalyst. The breakthrough was the unprecedented oxidative addition of an aryl nitro bond toward the palladium center, embodied by the bulky Bretfoss ligand. Owing to the generality of this elementary step, a wide range of nitroarenes and boronic acids could be applied for the modified Suzuki coupling. Part of the substrate scope reported in their work is presented here. They performed a set of control experiments to support the proposed mechanism of the reaction. A stoichiometric reaction of the palladium pre-catalyst and nitrobenzene in the presence of Bretfoss at 60 degrees resulted in the formation of an oxidative addition product via direct cleavage of the carbon-nitro bond. The obtained palladium-2 complex reacted with an aryl boronic acid in the presence of a base at room temperature to afford the corresponding biaryl. These results support the notion that the underlying reaction mechanism includes an oxidative addition, a transmetallation, and a reductive elimination, in a manner similar to Suzuki couplings involving other electrophiles. To sum it up, in this lecture, we learn the factors controlling the reactivity of electrophilic and nucleophilic coupling partners used in cross-coupling reactions. We have estimated the reactivity of common substrates based on their stereoelectronic properties. In the end, you saw how the rational selection of the catalytic system can influence the couplings involving unreactive substrates. With the knowledge we gained here about the reactivity of coupling partners, we can move forward to discuss issues regarding the selectivity in cross-couplings. In the following lecture, you will learn about the factors controlling the regio and chemoselectivity of cross-couplings involving multifunctionalized substrates. Thank you for your attention.